everybody's got to story things in their past. But what I don't get is, why does Gacy think he's the one that has any right to tell people what's okay and what's not okay? I mean, maybe he's the one with something to hide. People in glass houses shouldn't throw stones.
Gotta be honest with you. I think Gacy made a great point. Everybody wears masks all the time to hide their true selves. Everybody on the planet has something they want to hide. And in fairness to Boa, perhaps he was trying to hide a weakness.
And the cover, hook and leg off the backbreaker. And now we see that paint etched on the face of Boa, which Gacy was somewhat getting to. But, you know, Beth, I even saw your eyebrows raise when Gacy talked about Harlan.
Ugh. I mean, I'll be honest, I'm terrified of Harlan. But I'm also baffled as to what that relationship is. Gacy has some kind of, like, soothing power over Harlan.
Gacy into another cover, another hook of the leg, and Boa again able to kick out.
Gacy needs wins as much as anybody in NXT.
Speaking of that, you've been very critical in recent weeks of Boa, who really has stepped up his game.
Yeah, I told you something was not clicking with Boa as far as I was concerned. He made some changes, though. Perhaps he realized that himself. It's one thing to win a match, though. It's another thing to put together a string of wins, and he needs to do exactly that if he wants to climb the ladder here in NXT. But taking down Joe Gacy will be one way to take a few steps up that ladder.
We talked about how the face mask was going to affect the in-ring ability of Boa, and brought with it intimidation and upped his game quite a bit.
Listen to the NXT universe. What the?
Joe Gacy!
Some kind of intimidation. Boa looked absolutely out of it, and in the end,